for the scoring. Pass was picked off. Mittelstadt takes the return. Slides it across. Now Mittelstadt shoots and scores. The Sabres tie the game at one. Third of the season, Casey Mittelstadt.
The strength of their team here in the Flyers, not able to get the puck in deep, and because of that, the Flyers are able to transition. Two guys go to one, and Mittelstadt is able to kind of get loose from Zamula, and he's able to rip that one-timer home after the feed by Peterkin.
He's had some good looks here so far in this game, that being Jeff Skinner.
Paige Thompson, centering pass, score! 2-1 Buffalo just after the goal was waved off on the review. Biro scores the first of his NHL career.
Happy Valley, Hockey Valley, the former Penn Stater playing in his second National Hockey League game. What an effort and what a goal.
Got to get inside, right, Edzo? And Biro, not the biggest of guys, finds a way. There's orange sweaters there, but Biro is able to get in there and able to get a stick on it. And to me, for Hart.
Here comes Paige Thompson, 3-on-2 for Buffalo. Another odd man rush, dropping it back off. Score! 3-2 Sabres, Owen Power beating Ayrson.
And there you hear the help from the bench. Thompson realizes it's a 3-on-2. Excellent rush. Net front presence by Greenway, and then right off the post and in.
And the minute Greenway drove that.
Atlanta Studios talking about the Buffalo Sabres and moving forward.
Here's Thompson, score! Tage Thompson with his third point of the night. 4-2 Buffalo.
Tap on the backside of Dahlin to help, and back the other way, Bush.
And the guy you don't want the puck on his stick. And that's number 72 in white, Tage Thompson. And he can get it off quick, and he finds that far side.
Connected with a shot, saved by Lukanen.
I think Tippett got a piece of that.
Yeah, I think he did, Edzo.
That is empty. Score! Second of the night for Biro.
Now to find a way through as the Flyers try to stack it up a little bit, but the Sabres back mopping up. Mittelstadt in a stick battle, far side. Yoki Haru shoots and scores! Sabres are on the board! 4-1. Flyers with the lead, and maybe Buffalo now can keep chipping away a little bit.
Get his first of the year. Being aggressive, we talked about the D, being aggressive here in this third period, trying to get up in the offense. Exactly what you're looking for, nice feed right there. And he steps in, a quick shot, and he's going to be Ayrson on the short side.
Target, 28 goal scorer last year. They'll reset, and it's Peterka firing, scores, power play goal. And Buffalo has tied it
as well. That's a five-game streak for him. Three goals now in that stretch. But this is just simple power play tactics. Look at the positioning of Pozo in front. Wall takes a look around his left. I mean, you got to make a decision as a goaltender. You've got the screen of your own defenseman, Brody, and the one in front by Pozo. And the initial peek left there by Wall, that's when the shot happened.
By Tavares down right by the blue paint. But you just like the calmness of Devin Levi there. He didn't overreact, so he kept the stick on the ice, and Tavares couldn't find anything.
Tage Thompson breaks it up. He's got a break. Thompson in, stop, and scores. Short-handed rebound goal. And Tage Thompson, who couldn't beat Wolf on the power play, does. Short-handed.
There was no option, and he took a quick look to know it. Now you've got the last two guys that cannot turn the puck over. And this one just trickles through. As you see Joseph Wall's frustration, he felt that it was behind him and actually knocked it in himself.
2-2, here comes Lagesson with Gregor driving to the net. Puck doesn't arrive.
And back out comes Buffalo. Lead feed. Skinner's in. Shot scored. Jeff Skinner answers right back.
And Ryan Johnson gets his first point. He's the one who makes that pass. And the fourth line for the Leafs gets a chance. But how about Johnson not only getting past Reeves, but making a perfect pass in stride to Skinner. And Skinner just puts his head down here and just a wonderfully placed up and over. Teams in four nights, you think if they can ratchet it up a notch here, having played the intense that they have.
Here's a chance in front, and big stop, rebound, scores! Jordan Greenway, and again, Buffalo takes the lead.
That created the scoring chance. Here's a forecheck. Greenway keeps it alive along the boards. Paterka tries to get it out in front, and what a first save there by Wall. But on the rebound, Paterka with a nice pass that goes off the stick of Marner, but now Klingberg is tight to his net, and Greenway
to the cage. And the Sabres keep applying pressure. Flips it across. Dahlin scores. Hits somebody in front. And it's Alex Tuck.
Down low. Started from the corner. And this is a shot from Rasmus Dahlin, but right off the arm. And look at the reaction to Tuck. Just laughing here. You know, there's times when you make a great play and you got...
Gives it to Klingberg shooting and it's knocked down in front. Nylander trying to stop it up. Alex tucks away. Empty net. And Tuck is going to score again. And it's 6-4 Sabres.
There first, so now you get it alive. But this is a play that you just can't make if you're John Klingberg. It's just far too casual. A wrister right into the breadbasket that gets blocked.
To the slot, tipped out front, and they'll score! Oh, Alex Tuck with the turnover and stayed with it, and Buffalo's tied it at one.
Chatfield uses his skating ability and fronts the Sabres' crest, makes a good play, but Buffalo sticks with it. My gosh, that is some kind of play by Paterka out of the box.
Blue line, it comes in. Buffalo has to tag up. Now Dahlin with it. Dahlin played off the boards to himself. And he'll score! A surprise move caught everybody as Rasmus Dahlin passed to himself. And the Sabres defenseman has tied this at two on the power play.
What a shot. Thompson gets it to Dahlin coming underneath with speed. So he backs off the Hurricanes with that speed. Thompson creates, indirects it to himself. Puck was on edge. It's almost like he slinged it. I wonder if...
In front of the net. Cousins got a piece of it, but it comes back on the wall. Power sends it across. Scores! Henry Oki, are you with the blast? And the Sabres take the 1-0 lead with 1:58 remaining in period number one.
But what the Sabres have been able to do the last few minutes is just create havoc in the offensive zone. They're taking the pucks to the net. They're winning the battles. And they're really getting Minnesota running around here quite a bit. You see that shot from the point by Henry Yogiharju. You got Cousins there. You got Thompson in front. It sneaks right past Thompson. And it's going to enter the net.
Challenging a little bit more. One guy's got to come across and challenge a little bit. The offside D is taking that man driving through.
Here's a chance for Skinner now. Catching up to the puck on a breakaway. Skinner, deep scores!
But good pressure here. And Kiprasov not able to get that. And Jeff Skinner picks it up in motion and able to get separation. And when he does, he just puts a quick little move. You see how he got back on his heels and his skates? And changed direction real quick as soon as he started making the move towards the net. Got right on the heels right into the opportunity. He's earning every second he's on the ice. And Donny Granato's put him in really important situations, and he's handled them great.
Here's Thompson from Skinner in front. Scores! J.J. Paterka!
Yeah, Paterka's going to collect assist with a nice pass coming out of the zone. Cage Thompson right here with Skinner.
the two of them give and go coming down the wall. And the big thing is Thompson never lost any momentum taking this puck down low. And everybody's staring at those two guys, Skinner and Thompson, and J.J. Paterka is able to wheel the
Cousins off the wall. Sends it up top. Shot wide, rebound, score! Victor Olofsson gets the Sabres on the board with his first of the year. 5-1 Bruins, 4:53 remaining in the second period.
Tired out there, got caught for a long period of time, and the Sabres took advantage of that. Here's Owen Power with a quick shot. And it's going to pop right back out to Victor Olofsson, who's on his strong side. And he fires that one right underneath the bar. Shot from Power, looks like missed the net. Popped straight out off the back wall, and Victor Olofsson stepped right into it.
Beecher stops as he tried to get into the zone. Sabres come back with three. Mittelstadt on the right side. In the slot, this is Paterka right side with it. Feeds it to the front of the net. Olofsson serves and scores! Victor Olofsson gets his second of the night. Second of the season. With 4:58 to go in the third period, it's 5-2 Boston.
And the Sabres, they've done a good job here in this third period, just getting pucks deep and throwing to them that when they had to, just even overshooting. And every opportunity just turn and fire right there. Nice job by Olofsson. Runs the spinorama right there and puts it right through the legs at 73. And Linus Hallmark just not able to find it in time. It goes
working into the face-off circle. Skinner shot stop. Here's Alex Tuck, scores! Alex Tuck going to the front of the net where he does his work. Puck finds him. The Sabres cut the lead in half. It's now 2-1 Winnipeg. 15:04 to go in the second.
All night long. Good work along the wall by Dylan Cousins, Jeff Skinner right here. And Skinner just turns and fires this one to the net. And you see how Hellebuck, instead of corralling it in, he kicks it back out because Dylan Cousins coming through. Alex Tuck just turns and fires. And it's going to find the hole right there on the short side on the gloves.
Dylan keeps it in on the near wall. Quick play up by Rasmus Dahlin for Benson. It gives it back to the Sabres defenseman. Here's a breakaway pass here and a chance for Paterka again. Scores! That time it finds a home in the back of the net. And the Sabres are indeed just down a goal once again. It's 3-2 Winnipeg. A minute into this period.
Yeah, big goal here for the Sabres here. J.J. Paterka of the season. And he's had his opportunities, as we've said, but here he hits him behind the D this time. Kind of a role reversal, but first one stopped, it looked like Hellebuck, and then he does a follow-up with a rebound. There he does, takes the shot. Yeah, bang it is. He gets the rebound there, and then he puts it right back through the five-hole, it looks like, of Hellebuck, and bang, into the net, and it is a one-goal game here with exactly 19 minutes left.
For Mrazek. Mrazek has been brilliant, but Benson looking to test him again. Benson, the rookie, beats Dahlin, a shot, and that's a goal.
That's a goal and a screen, and there's some frustration certainly from Mrazek because it was a moving screen by his own guys, and after making a brilliant save on Benson with the left pad, Madison right there, watch him right in the middle of the ice, and I think the screen became right here. Watch in front, right there. Moved out of the way a little bit, but Kaiser didn't know where to go. It's kind of a tough spot right there, and obviously all the time in the world to let that one fly.
Bouncing puck for Dahlin. Down low, Skinner scores!
What a pass by Dahlin. He's got, oh my goodness, he's got a goal and a helper in this hockey game. And can this guy see the ice? And no one's anticipating this puck getting towards him. Tuck gets the battle behind the net. Paterka wins it. Everybody thinking that Dahlin's going to shoot this puck. The goalie's got to respect that. Remember, he walked down Main Street in the first period to score the goal, and here Skinner calmly takes it from the goal line, and his feet were behind the goal line. He brings it back on a better angle.
David Ross, by the way, that's Alanis Morissette, associate producer. I'll answer that in a second. He says it was 1991. Eric Johnson behind the net. No, it's in the net.
Oh, my goodness, what a shot from the sharp angle.
Eric Johnson unties this game with 9:24 to go in the third.
One of the Johnson scores here, and this was unexpected place as a right-hand shot down the side. He beats Jones, and here on a quick play, and this obviously surprises the goalie, Peter Mrazek, because of the play maybe of Dickinson right there, and it finds his way over the right shoulder, under the bar and in, through the legs of Dickinson. How it doesn't glance off any part of his stick or his shin pad is amazing in itself, and then over the shoulder and in the net.
Performance against Boston this season did Victor Olsson. Sabres still busy at the offensive end. Paterka closing. He scores! J.J. Paterka.
Miscommunication in front of the Capitals' net. They went to Paterka, and he can rip it. He's having a wonderful year coming off a very good year last year with 32 points. No one took Paterka. Watch what happens. Kicks back, and look at everybody in front. Look at how deep they are. And he's a sniper, and he rips it past the forward and the D, and absolutely no chance with Alexiev in front of the net. Could not see the puck, and he was screened big time. And there's the first goal of the game. Sort of a tradition. They always play the Wednesday before Thanksgiving and the Friday after Thanksgiving. And this place is jumping here tonight.
Look out. Backhand chance. Oh! Between the skates. Score! Wow! How's that for a first ever NHL goal?
An 18-year-old, Zach Benson. What a move. I think he's here to stay. First contract, look at this play, between the skates, right there. It's amazing how kids are able to jump right into the NHL. On my list, he's one of four that made the jump from this last year's draft. We've seen Fantilli, we see Benson tonight. Carlson we're going to see next week with the Ducks, and pretty soon we're going to see Connor Bedard with Chicago Blackhawks. An amazing move, especially as you nailed it, Joby.
Seconds. Sabres in white. Get it set. Dahlin, Cousins, lets it go! And rips the corner, it's 3-2.
Now the Caps penalty-killing successfulness down the drain there at the end of the penalty. They had gone 24 straight after killing off that 5-on-3. Tuck was 247, Mittelstadt 230, Dahlin over 2 minutes. And there's the Cousins slap shot past John Carlson and company right in front of the net. And there you see the goaltender. You could see him move his head a little bit. Did not see that rocket coming. And it's over the left hand.
Tuck, play catch along the boards. Alex Tuck in front. Skinner scores! Power play goal from Jeff Skinner. It's a one goal game here in the third.
Got an opportunity to clear the puck. 58 in front of the screen, in front of the net, and there's the play to Skinner. That's the goal. And it was offensive zone possession time for the Buffalo Sabres. Beautiful pass on an elbow play right to the middle. And you can see Nedeljkovic there. He's low, he's ready, but Jeff Skinner takes a look up top, and here's a look from our AT&T 5G net cam.
I tried to leave it there for O'Connor. Instead, it's Olofsson the other way. Victor Olofsson slows as he enters. Dahlin for Oposo, ripped to the front, they score! Kyle Oposo gets a friendly bounce, and the score is tied at 2.
Starts in their own end, and as they make their way up the ice, it's Olsson. He's got a lot of giddy up in his step, and there he stops and freezes everyone. Dahlin has got to be a factor as he throws that puck right to Oposo in there, that shot. Keep an eye on this puck. Kyle Oposo gets the goal here. He's on the board for the Buffalo Sabres, and that's a big one for this team. Has now tied things up. As you mentioned the number of opportunities he's had.
Off the glass, but not out. And Escorza shoved down by a pinched-in Samuelson, who was against the boards to block the second attempt. Skinner turning. Trying to bank it off the side of the goal. Picked it up again. Got it in front. They score! Alex Tuck! And the Sabres take the lead late.
And at the other end, at the end of a shift here, Skinner's he's just trying to throw pucks, maybe even get a whistle, but he's trying to throw it out front here. And as he does, he gets a bounce off the side of the net. How about Tuck's strength? He just bears down on that puck. He knows he's going to get confrontation in front. And the Penguins are just scrambling here, trying to do anything to keep that puck away from the front of the net.
Change directions. Comes down low to Tuck. 55 seconds left on the power play. Dahlin moves it. Tuck, extra pass. Skinner, he scores. So the Sabres get one back. It's 4-1.
And the Devils just have to play smart and make sure they don't take penalties, make sure they manage the puck, but this is a beautiful power play goal. And as now it's a 4-1 lead. Look at this pass right there from Tuck, and nobody picks up Skinner in the middle of the ice there, and he rips it past Vanacek.
This Siegenthaler. Area where the Sabres were really good last year, hadn't been as good this year before the goal tonight. Just 13% on the power play. Power through traffic, deflected again. So maybe that power play is starting to cook. Two goals today for Buffalo. They both come on the man advantage.
On the backhand, right there. It looks like that shot's going a little bit wide. And you see Kalapulso standing right in front of Vanacek, able to redirect that back on goal and in the back of the net. Right there. See that tip perfectly placed. No shot for Vanacek there.
Good shot, good shape. Buffalo only had 12 total shots in their loss to New Jersey on Saturday.
Puck kept in by Owen Power, blocked in front of the net, score! J.J. Paterka!
Oh, Buffalo Sabres finding ways. And Paterka
in their zone. And Gustafson tries to make a pass, does over to his partner, and then Ranger just couldn't get the puck out of his own. The attempted pass there goes right on the stick of Power. And so misfire on the pass by Ryan Lindgren.
Tuck puts it out in front, and the shot went wide. Down the board, Dahlin finds Paterka, saves Shesterkin, rebound score! Alex Tuck! And the Sabres have a 2-0 lead.
In front of the net, Mittelstadt with one shot, there's the save, but then the rebound, and Tuck gets to it. Tuck is a big guy, and he had position on Keandre Miller.
For 40 to go in the third, 2-1 Buffalo leading it, long pass ahead for Mittelstadt. He bumped with Miller, pass in the middle, Tuck shoots, he scores! Alex Tuck ripped the wrist shot over Igor Shesterkin to give Buffalo the two-goal lead again. It's 3-1.
Yeah, this was a one-on-one. Now Buffalo starts with Power, just throws it down the boards, and then here's the play, Mittelstadt and Miller. And Mittelstadt makes the play against Miller and gets it to Tuck, who just rips it home.
Whoa. They're set up in front. Off the corner boards to Kreider, then it's taken away and brought out by Skinner. He gets it to Mittelstadt, who puts it into the empty net. Rangers had the puck in the offensive zone, but couldn't get any shots, Joe.
No, they just kept on, they kept passing it around and the puck to the net, and eventually the pressure by Buffalo. They make the play. Skinner makes the play on the boards. Mittelstadt, who's had a strong game for Buffalo.
Joe and I will be back with you Saturday afternoon from Nashville. We're on the air at 4 o'clock with Rangers game night. The Sabres score on a sharp angle shot by Kalapulso. He has goals in three straight games.
That was a fabulous pass from Joakki Harju, who is back.
For Krebs. Kalapulso at the line. Dahlin scores with a one-timer and a bomb, and it's 3-1.
Moving side to side. The Sabres do a good job of moving that puck low to high and then back up to high here with some rotation. Big Greenway down in front of the net. That's not easy for Jordan Binnington to see around that guy, and he does a good job of.
Pierre at 12 years old with his family. And it was It was an incredible experience that I had as a young age and grew up around Pierre and his advice. And I used to go spend a month and a half in the summer with him. Coco, his wife, and Eric and Martin had an incredible impact. So I was welcomed to the family at an early age. And Pierre was my agent for many years and great advice I had at an early age.
Battle for the puck in the blue zone. Now Green Weiss steers it back to line. Dahlin, a drive right on goal. Rebound. They score. Krebs ties it. It's 3-3.
Sabres been all over the puck in the offensive zone. Go low to high with a one-timer there. Jordan Binnington makes the save. The rebound bounces out past Tyler Tucker right there, and the Krebs finds a home for it. Tie the game up at 3 apiece.
Sabres working around. Olofsson dusts it off in front to Benson. Back door. And a save by Binnington. And then they score. I thought he had covered it, but I think Peterka knocked it in at 6-4.
Referee Kelly Sutherland was right behind. Well, that's one thing you're doing as the Sabres. You're going to be trying to get the pucks to the net. So you're Justin Falk in front, battling away.
Yeah, that's why I thought it was covered, Jamie. Just sort of went right under his ball.